Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel. Hope you all are enjoying learning with Easy Dentistry. Today we are uploading a very important chapter from pharmacology, that is sulfonamides. Pharmacology is an extremely volatile subject, so you have to repeatedly watch these lectures to remember pharmacology. Visit our channel page Easy Dentistry by Dr. Pranali Satpute and you can find all lectures. The only motive of our channel is to provide knowledge to you all for free. You just have to do one thing, that is subscribe to our channel. Knowledge is a right of each student and there are no paid lecture for the students on our channel. So subscribe to our channel right now and also put on the notification bell if you do not want to miss any of our lecture. Visit our channel page Easy Dentistry and then visit the playlist section. You can find pharmacology playlist. Watch all the lectures of pharmacology to get thorough. So let us start with today's topic, that is sulfonamides. Sulfonamide is an antimicrobial agent. We will study this lecture in following subheadings: introduction, classification, antibacterial spectrum, the mechanism of action, resistance, pharmacokinetics, and the adverse effects, interactions, and finally the uses of the drug. So starting with the introduction, sulfonamide is the first antimicrobial agent which is used. Domax et al. Used Protoncil Red, that is sulfonamide cryzoidin, to treat the streptococcal infection in mice. Subsequently, an infant was also cured by Prontosil from streptococcal septicemia. So, in 1937, it was proven that Prontosil is broken down into the body to release sulfonylamide, and this sulfonylamide has antimicrobial action. So many sulfonamides were produced extensively, but rapid development of resistance shown by many microorganisms limited the use of sulfonamides. Also, combinations of sulfonamides were used which were found to be more beneficial. Sulfonamides, when combined with trimethoprim, the combination is called as cotrimoxazole. Then sulfonamides were also combined with pyrimethamine, which was used for the treatment of malaria. Now, the chemistry of sulfonamides, the sulfonamides are derivatives of sulfonylamide. The classification, sulfonamides are classified into four groups: short acting, intermediate acting, long acting, and special purpose sulfonamides. The short acting sulfonamide includes sulfadiazine. Intermediate acting sulfonamide includes sulfamethoxazole. Long acting sulfonamide includes sulfadoxine and sulfamethopyrazine. And the special purpose sulfonamides include sulfacetamide sodium, sulfasalazine, silver sulfadiazine, and mefenide. Now let us study the antibacterial spectrum of sulfonamides. Sulfonamides are mainly bacteriostatic and they are effective against a variety of gram-positive as well as gram-negative organisms. Sensitivity pattern amongst the microorganisms have changed from time to time and place to place. The sensitive organisms include Streptococcus pyogenes, Haemophilus influenzae, Haemophilus ducreyi, and Vibrio cholera. And few gonococci, meningococci, and pneumococci and E. coli are sensitive to sulfonamides, but the majority of these group is not. Now, the anaerobic bacteria are all resistant to sulfonamides, while Chlamydia, Nocardia, and Toxoplasma are sensitive to sulfonamides. Now, let us study the mechanism of action of sulfonamides. Now, normally, bacteria They synthesize folic acid by intake of PABA or para-aminobenzoic acid. Now, sulfonamides and PABA, that is para-aminobenzoic acid, are structural analogs of each other. The sulfonamides, they inhibit the bacterial folate synthase enzyme, so no more folic acid is formed, and thus the metabolic reactions in the bacteria are suffered or they decreases. Now let us study what causes resistance to sulfonamides. The resistant bacteria include gonococci, pneumococci, the majority of them, S. aureus, then meningococci, E. coli, Shigella, Streptococcus pyogenes, Streptococcus viridans, and all of the anaerobes are resistant to sulfonamides. Now, this resistance reduces its clinical use. Now, talking about the what is this mechanism of resistance, or why this resistance has developed? The bacteria are shown to produce more para-aminobenzoic acid. The resistant bacteria show increased production of para-aminobenzoic acid. Now, the resistant bacteria produce the folate synthase enzyme, which have a reduced affinity to sulfonamides. And the third mechanism is the resistant bacteria adopt an alternative pathway for folate metabolism. Now, talking about the pharmacokinetics, absorption of sulfonamides occurs in GIT. Plasma protein binding is 10 to 95%, which makes it longer acting. The drug is widely distributed in the body. It enters the CSF and also crosses the placenta. Now, the metabolism of sulfonamide occurs by acetylation at N4 by N-acetyl transferase enzyme, and this mostly occurs in liver. Now, the acetylated derivative of sulfonamide is inactive, which causes adverse effects on the body. Now, talking about each drug in the classification, sulfadiazine is the prototype sulfonamide. It is absorbed orally and is excreted in the urine. Sulfamethoxazole has a slower oral absorption. The T-half is around 10 hours and it is slowly excreted from the body. Sulfadoxine and sulfamethoxpyrazine are ultra-long acting. The duration of action is more than 1 week. There is more plasma protein binding shown by these drugs. The T-half of the drugs is 5 to 9 days and there is slow renal excretion of the drug. Sulfadiazine in combination with pyrimethamine is used in the treatment of malaria and toxoplasmosis. Sulfacetamide sodium is highly soluble drug and it is used in ocular infections. Sulfasalazine is used in the treatment of ulcerative colitis and rheumatoid arthritis. Mefenide is used in the treatment of Pseudomonas, Clostridia, and in burn dressing to prevent infection in the wound. Silver sulfonamide 1% cream is used over burns. It releases silver and this silver is said to have antimicrobial action. Now, what are the adverse effects of the sulfonamides? Nausea, vomiting, epigastric pain, crystallurea, rashes, hepatitis, and skin reactions are the adverse effects of sulfonamides. Now, the interactions of the drug. Sulfonamides reduces the metabolism of phenytoin, tolbutamide, and warfarin. It displaces methotrexate and thus reduces the renal excretion resulting into toxicity. Then, the uses of sulfonamide. The systemic use of a single drug of the sulfonamide group is very rare. It is used in combination. Then, ocular drops of sulfacetamide sodium 10 to 30% is used for the treatment of trachoma and conjunctivitis. Then topical silver sulfadiazine or mefenide is used to prevent infection of the burns. So here we complete with the lecture on sulfonamides. The next lecture will be on cotrimoxazole. That's all for now. Happy studying!